I think what's important is we're not going to do anything alone in the future as a military. We're going to look to do interagency, intergovernmental, multinational. And so the need for linguists is going to increase, and certainly the need for cultural understanding is critical.
Lieutenant General Robert Brown, the commanding general of the Combined Arms Center at Fort Leavenworth, visited the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center on August 21st, where he observed service members studying Turkish and Urdu.
Right now we have soldiers in 152 countries around the world. They're out there preventing conflict, they're shaping, they're deterring those that would do us harm. And God forbid, if the need arises, they can, and we have to go to war, they're better prepared to work with allies and multinational forces. So Defense Language Institute has a huge role in that, what do they bring? Cultural language training.
Just before deploying on a joint exercise to Japan last year, Brown said that he was fortunate to receive language and culture training for his soldiers at Joint Base Lewis McChord, Washington, where DLIFLC has a language training detachment.
And I think a huge part of that was trying to understand their culture better, not just coming in, if you will, as the ugly American, here's what we do and listen to us, we know everything, which we can tend to get like, you know, but understanding their culture, showing that respect, and it drew us closer together so that we really had a strong relationship.
The Army has a new concept it is proposing for improving military education. It is working on the establishment of an Army University under the Training and Doctrine Command that will provide accreditation for military schools, require more challenging curriculum, and ultimately offer soldiers a degree or certificate that will benefit them even if they decide to leave the military.
But as we looked at that, we realized, you know, we've got to increase the rigor in education, we've got to increase the value of education, and we had a lot of, within Training and Doctrine Command, some 86 separate schools that were all doing good things, but not synchronized very well. And we weren't benefiting from the good initiatives and ideas together. So Army University is an attempt to really increase the rigor in education, increase the value of education, increase the partnerships, and we'll take 86 TRADOC schools, put them under the umbrella of Army University.
Brown pointed out that 87% of soldiers do not stay in the Army until retirement.
Army University will help them transition easier. They'll get more credits they'll learn from classes they take, and certifications, whether you're a medic, a truck driver, a linguist, national level certifications, what we're looking at, Army University will help with that, so it'll really help the transition of soldiers, which is a key thing.
Brown indicated that DLIFLC is a prime example of the Army University concept, since the Institute already grants an Associate of Arts degree in foreign language.
I'm going to take a lot of what I saw back to Fort Leavenworth and look to share it with others and let them know what's available. And again, part of that Army University, DLI plays a critical role in leading the way in many ways that will help others.
As the Department of Defense's premier foreign language provider, DLIFLC currently teaches 23 languages to some 3,500 students from all four branches of the military service. Courses last between 26 and 64 weeks, depending on the difficulty of the language.